confirmed dead?
Do you think this could be the work of Joe Carroll's cult?
Not speculate.
When we start the season, Ryan's turned over a new leaf. He's healthy, he's not drinking, he's no longer in law enforcement, he's now a teacher.
Before you ask, I'm not involved, and I have no information about the subway murders.
Mr. Hardy.
But he gets roped in by the FBI in the investigation of this attack on the subway.
Are these your cult boys or a new fan club?
Could be both.
Ryan's actually trying to put the pieces back together, but he can't get away from Joe Carroll and Joe's cult.
Hey, I wish I could be more help, but you know, I'm strictly civilian now.
As the second season begins, the relationship between Ryan and Weston is strained, to say the least.
I reached out. What, you couldn't be bothered?
He's really confused why Ryan doesn't want to pursue the case and avenge Deborah and everybody else that was killed and hurt along the way.
I got nothing.
Oh, you are so full of it. You act like you're over it, but you're here because you care.
There is a Jekyll and Hyde aspect to Ryan this year. On the surface, he's really, really keeping it together. But in the darker corridors of his psyche, maybe not so much.
He wants the truth about Joe Carroll, and he's going to stop at nothing to get it.
Did you share what you know with the Bureau?
What, this? This is a hobby.
This isn't a hobby.
Ryan has taken the FBI's hunt and turned it into a one-man hunt. And he is still completely obsessed with Joe Carroll. So he really has become, you know, a vigilante.
His judgment gets clouded this season, and it puts him in sort of a very dark area.
You were in Havenport with Joe Carroll. Where is he?
He's dead.
Well, no, that's not true.
He really is going down a slippery slope.